Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today is tutorial number two for the blanket. Well, for learning how to make the crochet grafgans that I make. I apologise if the camera wobbles. I'm on my table. Riley's just there doing his schoolwork and the legs of my tripod are like kind of sticking out everywhere. So, right, okay. Last time I forgot to say, completely forgot, that when you are using DK wool, I don't think I said it anyway, it gives you an idea on the ball band of the size knitting needles that you need to use. I mean, there it says 4 millimeter, but when I'm using double knitting wool, I generally choose between a 4 and a 5. So you can have a 4, 4.5 or a 5 millimeter hook. I prefer the 4.5. That's my sweet spot. I absolutely love the 4.5 millimeter hook. So anyway, today you're going to need the piece you started last time and obviously the wool that's attached to it. And then today you're going to need a contrasting piece. I've just chosen yellow because it is so much different than this one. So you'll see easier, I hope. So you'll need a small ball of yellow. I haven't got one smaller than that of yellow. So it is what it is. We'll just go with it. I'm not planning on keeping this anyway. This is purely for your benefit only. So we're going to insert our hook into the loop that we left off last time, and then again you still have to remember to turn your piece. Hopefully you've all managed to find a way to comfortably hold the working end of your yarn. It can be tricky, but you'll find as you work you'll get used to it. Okay, so what we're first going to do is do half of the row in this orangey colour. It's like a burnt orange. Anyway, so we're going to start this next row. So the first thing we do is chain. So we just pull the working yarn through the loop on the hook and you have that chain sitting right there. So then we're going to go into this first stitch as we did last time. If I try and turn it on its side a little bit, you should see my camera's going blurry. So we go into that first stitch, grab the yarn, pull it through. You have two loops on the hook. Grab the yarn again, pull through both of those two. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go about halfway. So I can't remember if it was 20 or 21 stitches I had. So it doesn't matter. I'm going to do 10 of these. So there's the first one. Into the next one. Just as a quick refresher to what we did last time. Grab the yarn, pull it through. Two loops on the hook. Grab the yarn again and pull it through both loops on the hook. Remembering to turn your hook down so it slides through the stitches easily. So there's two. The next one, through, grab the yarn, pull it out. There's two loops on the hook, grab the yarn. So you can use this hand to twist that and grab it as necessary. Face down and pull it through both loops on the hook. Occasionally it will get caught, but I'm finding it's because I'm trying to look through the camera that mine's getting caught. So I've done three. So again, another one in this one. Four. I'm just going to whiz through because you learnt these in the last lesson. If you've got stuck, go back and watch it. Rewind as many times as necessary. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Right, let me go back. Number 9. Now I'm going to do one last one in here. Okay, but I've stopped because you need to, you can't complete the stitch, okay? So we're going to go in, grab that yarn, pull it through. You've got two loops on your hook. Now stop right there. You're not going to do anything else now with that yarn. You're just going to drop it at the back, okay? Because now you want your yellow yarn. Now, the slip knot I made in the first video, it is entirely up to you now whether you use a slip knot or whether you just leave the wool loose. I generally leave it loose and I just create a big loop even. Now this yellow one is going to pass through these two. Okay. Now the reason that is, if I tell you the reason why, hopefully it'll help you to remember that you don't finish the stitch. Because this yellow loop that you've just made, if that was in this colour, this yellow loop is what sits above your next stitch. So if that's orange and you're doing this in yellow, you're going to have an orange stripe. I'll show you exactly what I mean. just so it helps you guys to kind of think, okay, I need to stop there. So let's say, let's grab my yarn. I'm going into that next stitch now, right there, because you can see you've done into this one. So if I was to do this stitch now, grab that yarn and pull it through, and then pull through those two. Exactly as I said, you'd have this orange stripe above your yellow stitch, and you really don't want that. So you've always got to remember to stop at the two loops. Okay, so that's where you finish in the one colour. Okay, so next you're going to pick up your contrast yarn or whatever colour. I've just made like a loose loop, sorry, in my fingers. So we're just going to grab that yarn and pull it through the two loops on the hook. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to finish the rest of this row in yellow or whatever colour you've chosen for your contrast colour. Now this tail, it is entirely up to you whether you crochet over it or you leave it at the back and sew it in at a later point. I'm just deciding whether I should show you. No, I'm going to leave it at the back just because it's, you're trying to learn how to do it, and it can be sometimes trying to learn more than one thing is not good. So now that you've got the yellow yarn on your hook, you're going to go into this next stitch as normal. You're going to go through, grab the yarn, pull out, grab the yarn again, and pull through both of those two. So you've successfully changed colour. Okay, so we're going to keep going to the end. The same stitch that you've always been doing. In, grab the yarn, pull through those two. Okay, go through, grab the yarn, pull out. I've got to move my hands back, I keep going too far forward. Grab the yarn and pull through those two. Again, through, grab the yarn, pull it out. Make sure you keep that tension, but not too tight. Grab the yarn again, pull through those two. So we're just going to work our way to the end now, and I'm going to go slow with you just to make sure that you've understood. And sometimes if you've kind of done one and then you've just left it for a couple of days, you kind of need refreshing. So the next one, not forgetting that you need those two loops on the hook. Okay, if you've only got one, you're going to be left with a gap because that stitch then stretches. That's just one leg. Okay, make sure you've got the two and you don't end up with such a big hole. So through, grab the yarn, pull out, grab the yarn again, and pull through those two loops. And again, through, grab the yarn, pull it out, two loops, grab the yarn, and pull through those two. One last time, and then I'm just going to finish the row. Pull through, two loops on the hook, grab the yarn, pull through those two. So I'm just going to finish this row slowly so you can kind of stick with me. I'm getting used to looking through the camera now. There we go. Through, grab, and through both loops. Now this end one, it looks a bit of an odd stitch, but it is still a stitch just there. This is your side stitch, your step up. So you're going to go in there. Just make sure you've got the two loops. Grab the yarn, pull it through. Grab the yarn and pull through those two loops. Now you can always, which I quite often do, count your stitches to make sure you've got the right amount. I'm not going to, because this really doesn't matter. But you can feel free to pause and count your stitches, make sure that there's the same amount that you had before you did that row. And then you're going to flip your work clockwise, because you don't want to flip it the other way and have your yarn at the front. All right, so we're at the end of this row now, so now we're going to go back. So as with the start of every row, grab the yarn, pull through, and you've chained one. Okay, that's your step up stitch at the side. So we still need to go into this first stitch though. If you pull up on your yarn, you can see which is the first stitch. It's right there. Okay, so go through, grab your yarn, pull out, two loops on the hook, grab your yarn, pull through the two. And again, through, grab your yarn, pull out two loops, pull the yarn through those two loops. Now we're just going to go back to the colour change. and you can see where it is. So just keep going. And don't be put off by it because it looks technical. It really, really isn't. It's so easy once you've got it down. Okay, so we're coming up to the last one. So as you can tell, this is the last one. That loop looks a little bit bigger just because the yarn's loose down here. Well, we can sew that in later. Do you know what? I call it yarn all the time. It's wool to me, but I think I've got used to watching a lot of American videos, and it's just it is what it is. Anyway, this last stitch here, this last yellow, we're going to go in, grab the yarn, pull it out, and stop. Let go. I'm going to move this ball of wool to this side because when you flip your work, they twist. Now, I'm going to pick up the orange. Let's just give that yellow a little tug because sometimes you can pull and that loop will stretch. So you just give... I always hold it on the back of my work so it doesn't stretch too much. So we pick up the orange. Remember, this orange is going to sit above the next stitch. Grab the orange and pull through the two loops on the hook. You can always give that a tug again. Okay, so just remember that loop is going above the next stitch, so it needs to be in the same colour. Now, the only thing I will tell you is to be careful. Sometimes this very first stitch right here, if this loop coming from the yellow gets a bit too big, it can overshadow if you're not careful. And look, it almost hides that stitch right there. So give you whatever colour it is you've got there a little tug so you don't miss this first one. Okay, now we're going to go carry on exactly what we were doing before. Pull in, pull the yarn through two loops, grab the yarn, pull through the two. Now you're just going to keep doing that all the way to the end. Okay, so I'll still go slow because I don't want you to feel like I'm rushing, because when I stitch, I stitch. And once you get used to it, it just, your hands can go quite quick. I actually got complimented on it once when I took the kids to like an indoor play area. I took my crochet with me and this elderly gentleman came over to me and said, "We've been watching you for the past 10 minutes, he says, and you crochet so fast. He says, it's just, we were shocked, him and his wife. Right, we're at the last stitch here now. So just ignore this lumpy bit at the side right there. Look, this tiny little lump here, ignore that. That's the side. You want to go in that hole, sort of. It's not as obvious a hole as the rest of them, but you can tell from looking at it. And sometimes if you haven't chained one loosely enough, that can be a bit tricky to get into. So just give it a stretch, pull the yarn through, grab the yarn and pull through those two loops on the hook. Okay, so now we're going to flip back again. So turn your work clockwise and then transfer your wool, because otherwise these are just going to keep getting twisted. But we'll come to the bobbins on another video, so that you've not got to keep turning your balls and switching them. Anyway, beginning of the row, chain one. Okay, and then we're going to go back into this first stitch again. So I'm just going to I'm going to work my way along to the yellow so we can do that again. Okay, so we're at the last stitch now. We've got this last one to do. So in we go. Grab the yarn, pull it through and stop. Drop the yarn. If your yellow's sitting in front of the work, just pop it behind. Grab your contrast colour. Grab the yarn and pull through those two loops on the hook. Give that orange or whatever colour it is you've got a little tug just to make sure it's nice and tight. Now you've got this little line here, that's fine. That's just where you've colour changed. Okay, you won't notice it. So now we're going to go ahead and single crochet to the end, or double crochet if you live in the UK. And then I'm going to go back and do it one more time. And then we're back at the end one again. And like I said, you can tell that one, there's a hole, so you know where the stitch is. But this one at the end can always be a little bit tricky. You can sort of tell, so just give it a push, but make sure you've got the two loops of that stitch. Okay. So pull the yarn through and pull the yarn through the two loops. Now turn clockwise. Switch your balls again, just so they're not going to get twisted. Right. Now, this time I'm not going to make it the same stitch. Okay, let me just whiz across. So chain one to start the row into the first stitch. Work your way across. Because sometimes when you're doing the blankets that I do, your colour changes are not always in the same place. Sometimes you've got an extra stitch from the row before, or sometimes you've got one less stitch than the row before. So your colour changing is not in the same spot. Right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to decrease the yellows by one. So this is actually going to be my last stitch, not this one. Okay, so I'm going to go in, grab the yarn, pull out, there's two loops on my hook, stop, leave it there. So now we're going to pick up the second colour, whatever your second colour is, grab that. We're going to finish that stitch in that your first colour. Now you've got this bar, that's fine. Sorry, I'm trying to look between the camera and the piece of work I'm holding. You've got this bar, don't worry about it, just pull it to the left a little bit and do your next yellow stitch in the orange. And as you'll notice, that strand that's there gets tucked inside that stitch you've just done. Okay, now we're going to finish the row. All the way to the end. And back to this last stitch that doesn't look quite like a stitch, but it is. Go through there, finish that last stitch, chain one. You can either turn and then chain one, or chain one and then turn, it makes no difference. So now what I'm going to do this time, I've already chained one, so in here, but what I'm going to do is this time I'm going to do one extra. So it'll just follow the yellows on the other side. So I'm going to work my way across to the yellows. And if you need to rewind the video, that's fine. It's fiddly, it's not hard, but it can be fiddly trying to hold the keep the loop from getting too big. So we're not going to stop here. Okay, I'm actually going to go one extra this time. So I'm going to go into the first yellow. So I'm going to grab the yarn and pull up and stop. We've got to finish it in the contrast color. Okay, so grab the yellow. If it's only one stitch, I don't tie in, that'll come later. So don't worry about that for now. I'm only working one stitch, less or more. So now we're going to finish the row in yellow. Now, if you're working, your colour changes. Let's just say it is in the same place for a few rows. With this stitch, it's never perfectly straight, just because of the way the stitches sit. See, those two are the same. Yeah, the same amount of yellow stitches. I'm trying to think of what I was trying to say. But as you can see, it sits just ever so slightly to the right. And then it'd go left on the next row. Then it goes slightly right. Then it'd go left. So it's never a perfect straight. But it looks awesome. It really doesn't make a difference. So now we're at the end. I'm going to switch my wool back again and turn clockwise. So now we're going to chain one again. And we're going to work our way across to, I've ended up coming down again. Yeah, I'm going to work my way across to the colour change. Let's unroll that a little bit. Whoops. It's rolled across the table. So, go fluff. So now I'm just going to leave it in the same place this time. So into that last yellow stitch, pull the yarn through and stop. Pick up your contrast colour, grab the yarn and pull through those two to complete that stitch. Now just remember, you have to change colour because it goes above the next stitch, and this one's kind of hiding a little bit. So don't forget to go in there and complete the row in that colour. While I finish this row, I will say I am going to put out a couple more videos this week, but they're only for people who want to learn to crochet, not make the grafgans. If you want to make the grafgans, they're not for you until obviously I come to a point where I show you the other stitches that are involved if you want to do it a different way. Right, so into this last stitch and pull through the two. See, as you can tell, it jumps slightly to the right of the stitch below, even though it's in exactly the same thing. But if I finish this next row now, you'll see that the next one will go slightly to the left. So I'm going to do that just to show you. So we're going to grab. I haven't chained. You can always tell if you forget whether you've chained or not. You can always tell because this loop is coming out of the horizontal bar. When you've chained one, you get like that extra loop there, so you'll always know if you have or not. So I'm going to just slowly work my way back to the colour change. I do apologise, I keep moving my arms, it gets uncomfortable. So work your way across. And I'm going to colour change in exactly the same place again. So never ever worry that it's not straight. Right, this last stitch in orange. So we're going to go through, pull the yarn out, stop. Pick up your contrast colour and finish the stitch. Give that a little tug. And then we're just going to finish the row in your contrast colour. I hope you guys didn't think the last video I was kind of going a bit too slow. I didn't want you to think that. It was just I wanted to make sure that you all got it and understood, and I was kind of working along with you. Okay, so there we go. You got a bit of a dip in there now, and that's normal. That will never ever be a straight line, but that looks good. That does look good. If you need to, go back, rewind, start from the beginning again. I'm not going to show you how to organise your yarns. If you've got to go like two or three stitches into your other colour, I'll do that next time. So good luck with that, guys. Do a few rows, do a load of rows. practice makes perfect, doesn't it? So just get on with it. Next week. I'm not sure, I'll have to think about that now. Yeah, don't worry about that. I'll think about it later. Like I said, if you need to, rewind, start again, go through it, do as many rows as you like, just until you're comfortable, but always keep checking that you've still got the same amount of stitches. Whether you check at the end of every row or every other row or every few rows, just make sure you do, otherwise you're going to end up like with a triangular piece like this because you've kind of lost stitches, or it's going to go like that because you've accidentally gained. But if you lose a stitch, I think, don't worry about it for now. We'll come to that in another video. So good luck with that, guys. Have fun. Take care, stay safe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys.